What's up guys, Indian Sensei here. Welcome to another episode of Ninja Voltage. And today in this video, we are gonna see a detailed ranking of the best healers currently in the game. But before we begin the video, if you guys like my videos, drop down some likes and comments. And also if you're new, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. And one more thing is that I will only consider the healing parts in this video, not the support part. What I mean to say is some characters may be good healers, but they may be bad as support. And also this is just my ranking based on what I deduce from every character. Your thoughts might be different, which is cool. You may or may not agree with me, and you are allowed to have your own opinions, and you can let me know in the comments. So this is just a healing characters ranking, not the support part, just the healing. So let's jump into the video. So alright, at 5th position we have Karin with us. I don't know guys if you guys knew or not, but she was a pretty great healer in the anime, at least to Sasuke. But in this game they have not given her the ultimate jutsu, not any other useful attack jutsu or something, just a normal heal and speed buff. Although her heal is pretty high, but she is not gonna survive in the game even though she has a high heal. So she is the lowest ranking. There are more better characters than her in the game as of now. I don't know if it will change after the re-kit of Karin, maybe in the near future, but as of now she is the last. As you can see, she can heal about 2800 or something, but it isn't enough because she is not good at defense, because she doesn't have a lot of jutsus with her. So yeah, she is at last. So at 4th position we have Konan. Actually it was a tie between the 4th and the 3rd, so I decided to put her at 4th, you know, because I don't have her healing jutsu yet. She is a pretty balanced character. She has couple of jutsus with her, and also she has two ultimates, the old and the new one. Either one is fine, but the ultimate tends to miss sometimes, I don't know. But she is obviously better than Karin, as she has the full kit available for it. She has an ultimate, she has a couple of jutsus, so yeah, she is pretty great. But what she lacks is she is a blue character, so the attack is not that great, and the jutsus are actually not that great when using as a healer. So we are just gonna talk about the healing part, not the support part. She is a pretty good support, I would say, better than anyone else in the healing department, but we are just talking about the healing. So she might work if you don't have any other characters. So yeah, so as you can see, the attacks doesn't do a lot of damage. She has a couple of jutsus, but they are probably doing a lot less damage as we expected. I didn't put any of the kunais on her, just the vest. She used her ultimate, so yeah, she is pretty good to go as a healer. So she is at 4th, you might want to put her at 3rd, it's your call. I decided to put her at 4th, so yeah. So at 3rd position we have Sakura with us. So she is, I don't have her ultimate, the old or new, they both are okay. She is also a green character. She has some good jutsus with her, that's why I put her on the 3rd, because she is not that a great healer, but the jutsus on her are pretty great, especially this one, the defense debuff, the new 4 star, which decreases the defense of the enemies. She has a chakra control, the new 4 star, as well as she has one, I think, kick jutsu, which is okay, I guess, for damage. So you see, she is not that a good healer as Konan, but you know, other stuff also matters. So she is a good healer, I would say. 1600 power is pretty okay, but not that much. But she compensates all that with the defense debuff, so if she uses the defense debuff, it is pretty easy to kill a lot of powerful enemies with just one or two hits, as you will be seeing that I have Hokage Naruto in place here. So if she uses the defense debuff, I can just one or two hit Hokage Naruto with two of my jutsus and he is done. One is the fire style, other one is the Susanoo and he's done. So you see the heel is not pretty pretty much 1600, just 1600, but the other characters help her raise above Conan's level. So she is at third. You might differ, you might want to put her at fourth, but I think she compensates for her healing lack of healing power with the defense debuff. So once again, I tried to kill Hokage Naruto, but with the defense debuff, you can see just two hits and he is done. So yeah, Sakura is at third rank, 1600 HP recovering. That's pretty great, I would say. Not that much, just decent amount. And defense debuff, it's a really good jutsu. So now at second position we have Shizune. Yeah, she is our all-time favorite, especially the F2P ultimate that we got from the Sam, the best free-to-play ultimate you can get. It removes all the status elements for a period of time, I think 30 or 35 seconds, and pretty great jutsu to have. She uses it instantly as soon as either her or either the allies get hit. Also, she has a jutsu which paralyzes an enemy. She has a poison jutsu, kind of damage over time, as well as she has a heal jutsu. So she is the complete package. You know, she is a good at some kind of attacks. She paralyzes the enemy, so you can just easily kill the enemy. And the status element works fine, but we are just talking about the healing part. The healing is great, but again, support, she is not that good support, because if she gets separated from you, she is not gonna survive for that long, because she lacks attack power and stuff. Sakura would be better than Shizune in terms of support. So just in case of healing, she is pretty good. Now she has gotten hit by the slowed movement jutsu of Hokage Naruto. Now she has released the ultimate. Now we are immune against any type of status ailment. The attack debuff of Hokage Naruto, it is not affected, and the slowed movement. So she heals quite a lot. You can see 2480, pretty good healing HP, but as you can see, she will die because she doesn't have a lot of attack power. If you support her with a good character, she is great. So at number one position, we still have Tsunade as the best healer in the game as of now. She heals like insanely a lot of times, especially with the new 4 star as well as the old healing jutsu. If combined together, she just keep on healing. Sometimes this can be a downside, because the ultimate, especially the new ultimate, she will not be able to use the new ultimate if she just keeps healing herself, because she never gets less than 40% HP. Even if she gets less than 40% HP, she just restores it back. So yeah, there is that. So I am running with the new ultimate. I don't have the old ultimate. It is better. The old ultimate, it is better if you are using as a healing character, but I don't have it, so I am using the new one. And also the old 3 star, the healing jutsu, 6 second cooldown, 3700 power, which is really, really great. I think this is the maximum. And we have the new 4 star healing, which removes status ailment as well as recovers HP. So just combination of Hashirama's healing jutsu as well as Shizune's ultimate. So that's why she is above Shizune, because she has all that. She has the healing, she has the status ailment, she has the attack jutsus as well as attack ultimate. So I am using this 4 star, the new 4 star, instead of the old one, because it's I think the 3 second cooldown and bunch of stuff, extra special stuff included in this one. So yeah, you can go with either one if you don't have this one. So she is pretty balanced. The attack is also great, the HP, the defense, all things are great. That's why she is at number one. As you can see, she just keep on healing, man. She just keep on healing. So she might die, because if you don't have her old ult, but as a healing character, she is the best. You will see, he just heals. Just healed me. Now she healed it again. Yeah, so as a healer, you see she is doing pretty good, but support character, she is very, very low ranking. But we are talking about healing, so let me show you. I tried to actually have her use her new ultimate on Hokage Naruto, but I failed. I don't know why. Probably because she instantly restores HP when she falls below 40%. She doesn't care if she want to use her ultimate or not. She just keep on healing. As you can see, she drops below 40%. She doesn't need any concern. She just keeps on healing. So you just do your job of killing the enemy. She will do the job of healing you. So that's the important purpose of her. That's it. She is a bad support. I mean, if she gets separated from you, then she will probably die. But if you have her with your team, you just have to focus on killing the enemy and she will take care of the rest. She holds your back. She holds the team with her healing jutsus. What is he doing here? So yeah, he is a bonus character, guys. He is the new KLM Naruto. Of course, he is a healer too, but I didn't include him in the top rankings because he is a healer plus support. His basic function is not to heal, his basic function is to support. I should tell you guys, he is probably at SS rank in support ninjas. He is the top character in the support ninjas category as of now. So he is a bonus character for me. So yeah, Kurama Bite, it's a really great jutsu. It increases attack as well as defense. The healing jutsu, although it's a lot of 10 second cooldown, but it heals as well as turns all the allies on the same floor invincible for 2 seconds, which is pretty great for escaping ultimates and stuff. Although there is a 10 second cooldown in the healing, he uses it pretty often when necessary. So you will see, I will just leave him be with Hokage Naruto, and you will see that he can easily take care of any character in the game, even Hokage Naruto, who is a badass at defense. I just initiated, just use Susanoo Jutsu and the fire Jutsu, and I will go to the corner and let him handle himself. So he already used the heal one time. Now he's kicking ass and he is gonna defeat Hokage Naruto. Yeah, just like that. So yeah, you guys, yeah, heal, invincibility, what else you can ask for? He is the best support, man. So he is a bonus character in this video. Although he is not the main healer of the game, but he is a damn good support ninja. So guys, this was the ranking as of now. I don't know if there are any other characters coming on, but as of now, this is the ranking from my side. As I told earlier, your ranking may differ, but this is my opinion. So you can have your opinion and let me know in the comments what you think, and should I make more of these videos. And that's it, I guess. Yeah, so like the video, comment, do subscribe if you're new. Until then, sayonara.